Hi friends and students, April 18 is the day for all of amateur radio to celebrate and tell the world about the science we can help and teach, the community service we can provide and the fun we have with amateur radio. And today this year marks the 96th anniversary of the International Amateur Radio Union IARU, founded in 1925. International Radio Telegraph Conference in Paris. The IARU has chosen amateur radio home but never alone as the theme for WARD 2021. The theme acknowledged that during the physical distancing to reduce the spread of COVID-19, amateur radio sent out as a welcome respite for its variety of activities and opportunities. We hope you will join in the fun and education that is World Amateur Radio Day. Today, in the time of isolation, I am releasing online remote learning education series videos for radio regulations series and for amateur radios in India. Today, this time of isolation, I am releasing online remote learning education series videos for radio regulations. What is amateur radio or ham radio? Amateur radio is a scientific activity popularly known as a ham radio. Amateur radio operators use two-way radio stations and communicate with each other, similarly authorized using various modes of communication like voice, Morse code, using computer, internet, etc. The things that amateur radio operators do with their radios are as diverse as the people themselves. The advanced amateur radio communication technologies include automatic position reporting systems using GPS information, internet linking to repeater stations, interface with internet for exchange of emails, images, etc., as well as visual communication modes. Amateur radio is both a hobby activity as a service. If you want to know more, you have to Google it. Definition of amateur radio. Amateur service means a service of self-training, means you have to train yourself. Intercommunication means it is for communicating between similar authorized hams, and technical investigations means you have to communicate related to technical nature subjects, and it is carried on by amateurs, that is by person duly authorized under these rules, interested in radio technique solely with a personal aim and without any pecuniary interest. Means the person who is doing this service or activity is doing only for this personal interest and personal aim and have no any kind of commercial or business dealing with it. Just to quick remind you, for the ASOC examination, you shall have to go through for two parts of examination in written test. One part is for radio theory and practice, actually it is basic electronic. Section B is a National and International Telecommunication Union radio regulation applicable to operation of amateur station and those related to the working of station generally. Section A, radio theory and practice part, I am not going to discuss with these videos, so some other time I will give you details. To have a amateur radio license, you must have a sound knowledge for rules and regulation. Basically, it is a knowledge of the Indian Wireless Telegraph Rules 1973, the Indian Wireless Telegraph Amateur Radio Rules 1978, and subsequent amendments. I am not going to give you more details on whatever amendments I have done, but wherever I feel to tell you whatever changes happen with respect to previous amendment, I will tell you to compare. Who issues the amateur wireless licenses in India? The Wireless Planning and Coordination. A wing of Ministry of Communication created in 1952 is a National Radio Regulatory Authority responsible for frequency spectrum management, including licensing and caters for the need of all wireless users, including government and private, in the country. It exercises the statutory functions of the central government and issues licenses to establish, maintain and operate wireless stations. WPC is divided into major sections like licensing and regulations called LR, new technology group called NTG, and Standing Advisory Committee on Radio Frequency Allocation called SACFA, etc. Categories of amateur radio licenses in India. The government issues amateur wireless telegraph station license of two categories, namely restricted grade and general grade. Previous year in July 2020, the WPC had launched licensing module on Sarasanchal portal of DOT to ease of doing business and making the licensing process transparent. The DOT issues licenses through the online system on Sarasanchal portal. It is developed by ITPC of BSNL Pune. A lot of amateur radio clubs and societies are already explaining about it, and all new students going for ASOC examination must apply online on sarasanchal.gov.in. A screenshot is shown here. Details of examination. Restricted grade. This examination is consist of written test and will be of 1 hour duration. The maximum marks will be 100 and candidate must secure at least 40% in the E section and 50% in the aggregate for a pass. The other license is general grade. Apart from the theory part, one must also qualify in Morse code at 8 word per minute. The written test will be of 2 hour duration. The maximum mark will be 100 and the candidate must secure at least 50% in the E section and 60% in aggregate for a pass. In Morse code, the test piece will be consist of in a plain language passage of 200 characters, which may comprise of letters, figures. Test piece may also contain the following punctuations: full stop, comma, semicolon, break sign, hyphen, and question mark. Test will be for 5 consecutive minutes of speed at 8 word per minute. More than 5 mistakes will disqualify a candidate for this grade. Remember this. Who are eligible for amateur licenses in India? For citizens of India, the amateur license will be issued to anyone about 12 years of age who passes the ASOC exam. Holders of certificate of proficiency like radio communication operators, general or radio telegraph operators first or second class certificates are eligible for restricted amateur license without having any exams. Applicants holding degree in engineering, science or diploma in engineering and having studied electronics or telecommunication is exempted for appearing in Section A of Part 1 of the test. Licenses are also given to radio club, society, school, college or any other institution interested in this hobby, provided that the office bearer is having a general grade license holder. Reciprocal licenses. Foreign nationals are eligible for reciprocal license under the following condition. The country of which the applicant is a citizen should grant reciprocal licenses to Indian nationals. It may also not apply if the government thinks otherwise. The applicant must be above 18 years of age. The applicant must be holder of appropriate category of license. The license shall be initially granted for 1 year or for the validity of the visa, whatever is earlier. Function of amateur station. The function of amateur station is to communicate with other stations similarly licensed in the authorized frequency and modes. They can also conduct various experiments on amateur radio. Types of messages that can be transmitted by radio amateurs. Radio communications can be made with similar stations. Transmission must be in a plain language and limited to the messages of technical nature relating to test and to remarks of personal characters for which use of normal telecommunication facilities not justified. Of messages forbidden to be transmitted by radio amateurs. Reproduction of broadcast programs, tape recordings, transmission of entertainment values, music, false or misleading calls, news, advertisements, business communications, topics on political or industrial controversy, indecent languages, topics that can arouse racial, religious or communal feelings. Messages for monetary benefits and third-party messages are forbidden. We are also forbidden to contact stations of any other country whose administrations have informed the ITU of their objection to such radio communications. Conditions under which third-party messages are permitted. In case of failure of normal telecommunication facilities, amateurs are permitted to handle third-party messages relating to natural calamities like earthquakes, floods, cyclones, widespread fires, etc. The messages must originate from and must be addressed to district collectors, district magistrate, deputy commissioners, or any other official authorized by them. We have to inform our licensing authority regarding it also.
Secrecy of correspondence. If any message which is not entitled to be received is nevertheless received, we shall not make it known its contents, its origin and destination, its existence or the fact of its receipt to any person other than a duly authorized officer of the central government or competent legal tribunal. It shall not be reproduced in writing, copied or made use of.
Phonetics. It is a branch of linguistics that studies how humans make and perceive sounds, or in the case of sign language, the equivalent aspect of sign. They are necessary because of the similarity of many English alphabets. So all voice-operated stations find it necessary to use a standard list of words to signify each word, to give the call signs, name, location, etc. This will avoid any confusion while exchanging messages. The standard list of phonetics suggested by the International Telecommunication Union is as follows. For the alphabet A, we use the phonetics alpha. Same way, for B, bravo, C, Charlie, D, delta, E, echo, F, foxtrot, G, golf, H, hotel, I, India, J, Juliet, K, kilo, L, lima, M, Mike, N, November, O, Oscar, P, Papa, Q, Quebec, R, Romeo, S, Sierra, T, Tango, U, Uniform, V, Victor, W, Whiskey, X, X-ray, Y, Yankee, Z, Zulu. When I am exchanging my name to someone, especially a ham, on HF, in noisy environment, even I am pronouncing right my name as Sushil, but there are plenty of chances that other person will listen as Sushil or Shushil or Shushil or lot of mistakes possible. To clarify my actual name, I will use a phonetic system and speak individual phonetics, and other person will pick first letter of that phonetic one by one. Example, I am saying Sierra, pick S, uniform, pick U, Sierra, again pick S, hotel, pick H, India, I, Lima, L. So this is my name, S-U-S-H-I-L, Sushil. So this way you have to do practice. Lot of people know the phonetics of alphabets like A alpha, B bravo, C charlie, etc. But not many people know that there is a numerical equivalent also. Example, for number 1, we use the phonetic una 1. For number 2, biso 2. 3, tera 3. 4, kate 4. 5, panta 5. 6, soxi 6. 7, sete 7. 8, Octo 8, 9, Nove 9, 0, Nada 0. Abbreviations. An abbreviation is a shortened form of written words or phrases. Abbreviation may be used to save space and time, to avoid repetition of long words and phrases, or simply to conform to conventional uses, e.g. stand for exempli gratia and means for example. As per Amateur Station Operator Certificate Examination, you have to remember just the following abbreviations. AA stand for All After, AB, all before, AR bar. This bar means these two letters are coming continuously and there is no space in between sending as a single letter in Morse code. So AR bar stand for ending signal, AS bar, please wait, BK bar, break, C, yes, CFM, confirm, CL, closing down, CQ, general call for all station. 73 stand for best regards, 88 love and kisses, OM, this word used for male operator of any age and this have a meaning old man. DE stand for this is, K, go ahead, nil, I have nothing for you, okay, all correct, R, Roger, or also received fully, TU, thank you, VA bar, end of contact, WA, word after, WB, word before, sometime, some operator use as a number 55 as a good luck, but this is not a syllabus, but you remember it, YL, young lady, a lady operator of any age, HH bar, error in sending. Thanks for watching. This is end of the part. Section B, radio regulations. Your valuable comments and suggestions will encourage us to provide you an even better education series lectures on amateur station operator certificate topics. Students, I remind you again, don't just depend on these lecture series. Kindly go through books and regular classes also.